I made this single speed flat bar commuter bike in this shop a little over a year ago. Let me tell you all about it. It's got all sorts of really cool features in it. It's got my cool head badge, the snake wearing sunglasses. He doesn't care. He's having a great time. The fork is a segmented fork that I recycled from another bike that I had made. I made a bike with this fork, and then I made a different fork for that bike with a little bit more rake to play with geometry. You know, that way I was able to test the variables. I knew that I was only changing one variable, and it gave me a better sense of you know, learning a little bit about how changing just the rake of the fork would affect the geometry of the bike. So I had this kicking around. I just painted it to match. What else do I got going on in the frame here? I actually took this head tube on the lathe. I turned it, it was a heavy wall, 37 millimeter outside diameter head tube, and I turned it so you have these reinforcing rings on the top and the bottom. Sometimes you can braze something like this onto a head tube, but this was actually machined this way, which I thought was pretty cool. So it's just to the length I wanted, and the steps on the end were just as long as I wanted them. Over here, I did what's called a C-post collar, and so it slips into the end of this tube, and you fusion weld it in, and it's on the outside, it's the same diameter as this, 1¼ inches. On the inside, it's the diameter of your seat post, 27.2 millimeters, and what that does is it gives you a little bit more meat to weld to so that the welding distortion doesn't create so much of a headache for you. It's also heavier and stronger there at that joint, but then it's a relatively thin tube for the rest of its length, and so those are real popular on mountain bikes, and this was the first bike that I got to try that on. I wouldn't have needed it for this, but I wanted to try that out. On the rear end here, I got the single bend rear end like I talked about on my bike with the fade paint job, and it's very subtle, but there's just a bend somewhere in here on each of these, just a little bit so that I have a little bit more tire clearance than if the tube went from this point with no bend. Gives me the right amount of gap I want here. And then I smooshed the tire down here, or I smooshed the chainstays for tire clearance, and that came out pretty nice. Pretty happy with the way that that looks. You can see just a little bit of a mark there, and you know, that's not perfect. It's not horrendous, but you know, I wouldn't want that on a customer bike. And so, you know, I got to kind of try that out on this bike and decide that it wasn't quite ready for prime time yet. So the story with this bike was that I had a really nice bicycle, the one with the fade paint job, and I had a mountain bike, but I didn't have a good bike for riding around town and locking up somewhere. And so I had this nice Velocity rim and Paul components wheel set, and I had a handful of these other parts, then I seat post and the cranks. Some of these parts are pretty standard and some of them are pretty nice, and I just had a lot of this stuff around, and I said, you know, for a couple $100 I can buy the rest of the parts and the tubes. And I was working a full-time job. I didn't really feel like selling bikes to customers and you know, doing actual like trade shows and stuff. This was I started building this in the fall of 2017, and I was just having fun with it, and I wanted a nice commuter. I had wanted a bike like this for a long time, actually, and you know, I wanted something with flat bars, because when you're climbing a hill on a single speed, if the bars are a little bit wide, you know, more like a mountain bike, you can actually kind of reef on them and gives you good leverage. And then, you know, single speed is just a simple commuter bike. You don't have as many parts to get, you know, there's in the winter months of the year, there's salt on the roads and stuff. So I wanted something that was simple to maintain and lightweight. Plus I already had a single speed wheel set. I maybe would have used disc brakes, but these were rim brake wheels. So I used V brakes rather than rim caliper brakes for a road bike. And I love V-brakes for this kind of thing. I was gonna go with flat bars anyway, so the pull ratio for the cable to use V-brakes is no sweat. And they just, you know, they're simple to adjust, and they're nice and strong, and you know, they're cheap. I think these are like $20 retail for a pair of these brakes. And so there's nothing that special going on in this build. It's just a lot of solid parts. I got plastic BMX pedals. These are like, you know, $10 pedals or something, but they give you a nice big platform for your shoe. You don't need to wear your clipless shoes. You can wear whatever you're gonna wear as you go to the library or the bar or wherever it is you're going in town on your commuter bike. You just got nice big sure-footed pedals. I like that. You know, it's just simple and solid. I got the water bottle cage so I can bring a water bottle or you know, a can of beer or whatever it is where I'm going on the bike, depending on the occasion. Really simple headset. This doesn't even have a cartridge bearing in there. It's just the balls and the retainer, and it's like a $20 headset. It works fine though. You get it adjusted with grease and it works fine. And so, you know, there's this the custom bike world, rightfully so, gets to be pretty fancy and pretty sophisticated. As I mentioned in the overview of my bike with the fade paint job, that one is not even that fancy by custom bike standards in the custom bike world. And yet for me, it is very fancy. It is very nice. I love it, but it's like kind of too nice to live with sometimes. You can't even lock it up anywhere. I did lock it up once and I chipped the paint and I almost shed a tear over that. You know, and this, I threw this together with tubing that I had around, parts that I had around. I spray painted this with a rattle can. It doesn't look that good if you get up close. You can see I actually spray painted the whole bike just with Rust-Oleum rattle can spray paint that I got at the hardware store. I just, you know, I didn't want to spend a whole lot of money on this project. It's supposed to be something that I can ride in all kinds of weather and I can leave it locked up without worrying about it. And it was an opportunity for me to practice that. I sandblasted it at work where I used to work. They had a sandblaster, and then I spray painted it with a coat or two of primer and top coat, and it looks pretty bad up close, but it does the job. And so this whole project was an opportunity for me to try frame building from a different angle. Typically, you wouldn't bother custom building something and making it by hand to only put on solid basic parts. You know, usually you're trying to make something beautiful and extraordinary, but you know, I just love fabricating so much. And at this point in my life, I was just working this other job, trying to learn what I could about CNC machining. And I just wanted to have a commuter bike and I wanted to make it a certain way. And so I custom built it, and it was a really satisfying project. Actually, I was kind of happy to have an opportunity to do frame building in like a lowbrow, basic, bare bones sort of way. It was kind of a nice break from the way that I had been pursuing it more when I was making bikes, you know, for myself and for other people that were supposed to be, you know, communicating something a little bit nicer and more refined. This was a fun sort of change of pace for me. I love these grips. You know, I have a $20 headset, or maybe it's $10 headset. It's a cheap headset. Some of these parts are nothing special, but I knew certain parts of the bike I did want to be nice. The wheel set is pretty good, and these grips are lock-on Aury grips. I think the rubbery compound that they use on these grips just feels great, and the lock-on, you know, they just stay put, and it's just really solid. There's certain things about this bike that make it feel so nice. The big platform pad. These are plastic and the bearings suck, but they're solid under your feet. And you know, it's a square taper crank. It's ancient technology, but it's solid stuff, right? This is a cheap freewheel, but the wheels are relatively light and stiff and the bearings are good. And so I think this bike doesn't have any more than it needs in a lot of places, but it has it where it counts. It's very solid. It's actually pretty lightweight. I would think that this bike is probably like 22 pounds or it's not that heavy. I don't know exactly what it weighs. It's not a very heavy bike for what it is. This would be a really good project if you were getting started frame building and you're newer to frame building. This style of frame is easier to make as a novice. If you don't have all the fixtures, all the years of experience, you can get away with that, because with the rear end, you have these single speed dropouts, and if your wheel alignment isn't perfect when you're done, you can adjust at least forward and backward along the length of the chainstay to get the wheel to center. You can't do that with through axle, and you can't really do that very much with vertical dropouts. So that's one element that makes it easier. Also, V-brakes, you know, locating these canny studs on the frame and welding them on, I think is a little bit easier than doing a disc brake tab. Well, it depends. If you just buy dropouts that have an integrated disc brake tab, that's pretty easy too. And then the parts that go onto it, you know, you can use straight gauge chromoly tubing, and that's not going to cost you that much money. And then, you know, you can use cheap crankset, you know, relatively cheap wheels and other parts you scavenge from something else, and you could get the experience and the practice, the satisfaction of making your own bike for not a whole lot of money invested. So if you're just getting started, I think this is a really good kind of project, and then you get to ride it around and you can tell everybody about it. So anyway, hope you found the video helpful, and hit that subscribe button. We'll see you on the next one. I made this single speed.